Any business.
Gone from Texas Streetcars in the shop today. We have a 1975 Oldsmobile Cutlass Salon. Really clean, really original car. It's believed to be 46,000 original miles. We'll kind of talk about the options it has, and then we'll go drive it here in a second. So to start, the exterior is persimmon. You know, it's kind of an orange metallic-y finish. Really cool color on this, factory color. White vinyl top, and then the dark brown tan interior. The interior of this car looks really nice. We'll talk about it in a second, but exterior-wise, really clean. No major paint flaws, no dents, no dings. Earlier in the video, I walked around the bottom of the fenders, no rust coming through. The car was repainted at some point in its life, and really high quality paint job on it, above kind of driver quality. The only thing on the paint is, one of the videos, a little spider web, and on one of the bumper fillers just on this side, but the rest of the bumper fillers are really clean. The bumpers are clean. It has all the trim on it, all the stainless around the windows and the hood, and the hood piece are all really nice. Factory 15-inch wheels with the factory hubcaps, a kind of cool design. Brand new tires. It is an Oldsmobile 350, power steering, power brakes, AC, It's a bucket seat car. The interior's my favorite part of this car. It's a bucket seat console with a floor shifter. And I really like the style on the interior of this car. The seats are super plush. They're nice shape. The console is obviously pretty cool looking. The AC vents are really nice. They're like modern cars with the little centerpiece will close them. Steering wheel is, you know, most of these old 70s cars, the steering wheel is real thin. That car is like vinyl wrap. It's really thick steering wheel. It's kind of cool. Different than what I'm used to seeing in these 70s cars. Windows work, locks work. It's roll up window, manual lock car. Interior is really nice. Headliner, all the lights work. You can see it in the video. The radio works. All the dash lights, even the high beam indicator, all that stuff's working. Doors and hood, and trunk, everything open really good on this car. Back of this car, one of the cool things on it is, you know, all these older 70 cars, you put down the license plates wherever you get fuel. This one's fuel is here, and it has like a little nice door that covers it. All the trim back here is really nice. All the lights work. Glass is in great shape. This rear glass is kind of a cool look to it. No chips in the glass, something like that. It even has all the, you know, the paint filling on the door handles. Really nice car, original GM floor mats in it. We go on and on about the originality. Underhood has all the stickers and everything, the Oldsmobile air cleaner. Car drives great, runs really well. We'll get out and drive out on the highway here in a second. Stock exhaust, nothing crazy there. But really nice old car. If you wanted something to jump in and drive, the AC works. And nice look to it. Really good finish on it. So we'll go drive it. If you have any questions, give us a call at 254-383-3517. We'll go drive the olds around. You can pan down here. This is my favorite part of this car is the lockout shifter thing, the console. Another cool thing is like these door pulls are also like a matte puck. Pretty fancy, huh? Oldsmobile knew what they were doing. Look at these badass vents. You got 36 ashtrays. And I don't know when cars started having the high beam off the floor, but this one actually has it on the column, like for turn the high beams on and off. Do you know when, cameraman?
Sometime in the 70s.
Probably 75.
Yeah?
Yep. Radio works. Even the little stereo light comes on when you get it tuned in to your favorite oldie station. AC works good in this car. Interiors is wild in this, how clean it is. Dash isn't cracked. The steering wheel's my favorite part. It's like vinyl wrap to be a little thicker. Horn works. Obviously, this isn't a race car, but brakes good. It's got enough power to go cruise. You could throw your kids in the back. Is it three seats back there?
Yep.
So yeah, you can throw three kids back there. Headliner's in really good shape. I like the color of this interior too. It's pretty cool. All the text for the AC and the wipers and everything is all clear and clean. Dash lights all work. Oil pressure's at 60 right now. Temp's good. We've been driving around for a little bit. Around probably 190. Fuel gauge works, speedometer works. Odometer says 46,109, so really crazy. Somebody must have kept this nice. Antennas in the mirror, so you've got some ugly antenna to take away from the styling of the 70s.
You mean in the window?
Yeah. Adjustable mirror here. This car is super quiet. There's no rattles or anything in here. And this is the road we normally drive our lowered trucks down. So I'm at 30 down this road in this and nothing. So soaks up the bumps like you would expect one of these old cars to do. Listen to that quality turn signal noise too. We'll go take it up on the highway. But shift's good. Seatbelt retractors all work. Ready for a brake check. This must have the Brembo drums in the rear. I can't find the RPO, but maybe it does. Seats are really comfortable, these big wide seats. There's no rips in them, no tears. Again, I really like this shifter thing. hide your, I assume you'd carry a revolver back here in 75. Throw your snub-nosed revolver in there and pull that shut.
Marlboro cigarettes.
Yep. Maybe a cooler. Not bad on power. Good shift there. That's up to 60. You roll up this window. Window rolls up good. Doesn't stick or nothing. Alright, we'll do a U-turn in this. Obviously no rubber ring with the stock tires. That's it. Back up to 60 or so with the windows up, up on the highway. Wind noise is very minimal. Really quiet, this car. So, super clean old if you want something to cruise around. I like to see this car really low with some nice, you know, put some great torque press on it or some old school looking wheel would be kind of neat. But this is stock exhaust, nothing changed from factory, air cleaner stock, stock wheels, hubcaps, tire sizes are on the stock size. So really original, solid driving Oldsmobile. We'll have a bunch of pictures of it up. Let's check out the steering of this. Autocross car. Steering's really tight on it, man. The steering box is good. I like this old car. All the, like I shown earlier in the video, the center console light works, the underhood light works, the trunk light. That light. What do you call that light? A map light?
Yeah.
Your map light so you can navigate across the country. So, really solid Oldsmobile. It's fun to drive. It gets a lot of looks. The color combo is really cool. I like this orange and white with this color interior. So give us a call if you have any questions. We'll have a bunch of pictures up. Financing available on this. This car actually belongs to one of our good friends, Bobby, who is kind of an Oldsmobile collector. I say kind of. He has a ton of Oldsmobiles. So he buys these cars. He perfects little stuff on them, gets them running and driving really good. And this is one of his cars. The 77 Cutlass we had last year was also his. So he has really nice stuff. So we enjoy selling cars for him, but really solid car here at Rev Up. Again, if you have any questions, give us a call. You can check out those interior lights working back there. 12 ashtrays in the back, I'm sure, on the back of the seats. Rear package tray is nice. It's wild how nice the interior of this car is. So look over the pictures and thank you guys for watching.